Hey friends. Oh, namaste.
So nice to see your love pouring in. And also how we're all sharing love with each other. It's really like we're all regathering in this circle that we are every day. Just wanted to let you know about a beautiful event I just found out about, which happens tomorrow, which is called Canta con Amor. And I just posted it on Facebook, but I think it's also happening on Instagram live tomorrow, pretty much 8 hours, beautiful music from beautiful friends of ours who make music, ceremonial, sacred music. So check it out, and we'll see each other there, I'm sure.
It's beautiful. And you see, you might have noticed we're back outside again. It doesn't look like rain right now, and if it rains, I think we can just carry on.
We'll get away with it.
We'll get away with it, yeah. Yeah, get away with it. How's life? I hope you're doing okay. We have no idea, of course, any of us, when this thing is going to stop or change or whatever's going to happen. None of us know. Isn't that amazing? None of us know. Nobody knows. We're all making plans. I guess all the governments are making plans. But nobody knows. So for the first time ever in our world, we're all in the same boat. We're all concerned. And we're all right now in a place where we didn't plan to be at this point in our lives. This is a one.
Well, this is true.
It's true, isn't it? When all of us are in a different place to the one we thought we were going to be in. So,
So that is a reason to celebrate.
It's to celebrate, yeah. Yeah, well, I mean, the thing I feel like, you know, that's the key. You know, what do we celebrate? What are we celebrating? First of all, we can celebrate this feeling of, wow, no work, no office, no factory, no...
People are still working.
Huh?
People are still working from home.
From home, yeah. Yeah, I'm talking about no office or no factory,
okay.
You know, or
okay.
No car.
Okay.
Yeah. I lost my thread.
You were saying, what can we celebrate? I mean, just sitting here is the reason to celebrate, that we sit here and we can breathe and that we can sing.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
that we can remind each other to be in the moment and to be in gratitude for whatever happens, whatever is.
Yeah. Yeah. I think that's what I was getting to, is that, you know, instead of all those places where we would have been, we are somehow connecting to friends all over the world that we would not have been connecting to otherwise. And
community.
Yeah, it's our community. This is our community. And it's growing stronger, and it's growing in more love every day as we continue to share. It's kind of good that we don't have any answers, because we're left, like Dave was saying, we're in the moment. This is it. This is it. And wherever we are, if we're sitting down meditating, watching this, then every one of us knows that our lives could be a lot worse than they are right now. This is a great opportunity to give thanks. Through our meditation, through our participation, and our celebration. So we get ready for our meditation, light the candles, light the incense, get comfortable. Get yourself comfortable in preparation, and when you feel ready, close your eyes and come home. And remember, these gatherings with Dave and myself are all about slowing down, slowing down. Slowing down. awareness to the sounds around us, in the garden outside or in the road. Looking for that inner smile that's down in your belly. And raising your eyes to your third eye behind your closed eyes. Just raising up your eyes to your third eye, your sixth chakra. And you feel the light of who you are.
Today when we start with an Aum meditation, we can picture the sound Aum as it consists out of four phases. A, we can invoke Brahma, the creator. A is the first letter of the alphabet, it's the beginning, it's the creation. A. U is the sustainer, Vishnu. And M is Shiva, the transformer. And then we go to the fourth phase, which doesn't need a name, it's just called the fourth, Turiya. And that's when we take that big breath to start the cycle over again. It's that silent space in between, that pause, the rest, before the cycle renews itself with Ah as the creation. And altogether it's Aum. And every one of these sounds has an equal amount of breath and importance and emphasis. So we really feel each one of those four phases. Also, you know, when you intone that sound of Aum, let your body be involved. You don't have to get rigid or keep your body still intentionally. Just let your body move however it wants to. If it wants to sway with the sound, or if your arms or hands want to dance with the sound, just don't hold anything back, just let your body be the guide of what's the healing movement for you right now. And today we'd like to dedicate this meditation to Matthew and Louise, Lindsay and Emma. Start with a big breath and big breath. Thank you.
servitur varia, margo deva sia di mai, Dio Jonas, placio dai.
Next round, how about if we get up and move around the space where we're living in, the space that we see so much, that we know so well, and we can do that with namaste and really honoring everything that we've invited into our space, into our lives, into our homes. Give gratitude for creating a space for us, for creating that feeling of home, and also seeing everything with fresh eyes, and just really making our space even more sacred by charging all the things around us with gratitude and love and appreciation and respect. one more round where we close our eyes, put our hands on our hearts, and just honoring the sacred temple that we are, that we are, that we are, with all our seven chakras, every fiber of our being, divine beings that we are.
woke up laughing. Strange but true. I was dreaming of a white swan and this silent space with you. I saw a color reflected. I saw it silver and blue. I saw that white swan in a flash of light in that silent space with you. And it's more than romance, it's more than sexual. This is a one-to-one, full-on connection. And I don't need to hear your voice to feel your heartbeat. I don't need a body to contain this love. The shining water. I sing that again. Something was biting me. Across the shining water, that white swan flew. As the longing increases, the sun comes shining through. I see my only release is this silent space. It's more than romance, it's more than sexual. This is a one-to-one, full-on connection. And I don't need to hear your voice to feel your heartbeat. I don't need a body to contain this love. And I woke up laughing. It's nothing new, 'cause every day is a miracle in this silent space with you, in this silent space with you.
Just for those of us who go to bed soon, or those of you, we don't go to bed yet, but just to remind you of that beautiful meditation to in tone the sound of Om or Aum each time on each out breath as you fall asleep, and just to let the Om sound carry you into sleep, and try to stay present with it as long as you can, and then sleep takes over. This will make the Om sound accompany you all night long, and you will wake up with the sound of Om on your lips, which is the best thing to do. Thank you for another beautiful meditation. This is so precious and just so touched. Somebody said, when you sing, I become like a sweet teenager. I feel like one. No car? Sorry?
Samaska Sukino Bhavantu Loka Samasta Sukino Bhavantu Loka Samasta Sukino Bhavantu. Shanti, shanti, shanti.
Namaste.
Namaste, friends.
Namaste.